Right, let me talk to you for a minute, Kwame Brown. Everybody sent me your little video. Now let me say this respectfully, right? I'm gonna be as respectful as I can be. First and foremost, when I say don't compare me to an NBA player or none of you celebrities, like you, for example, I'm not glorifying. Don't play military mind games with the people. I'm not glorifying prison by any means. When I say at 18 years old, I went to the penitentiary, and at 18 years old, you went to the NBA, it's not because I'm glorifying. It's because there was a long path that led to my downfall going to the penitentiary. There's a story in between of pain, is what I was trying to say. And see, that's the thing that's lacking, that's missing in your story. My story is filled with pain from childhood. Your story and your pain consists of Michael Jordan elbowing you in the face, or Pat Riley smacking you in the back of the neck, telling you to do 100 miles. My pain consists of not having a father, sitting outside on welfare cheese lines, going to the stores with food stamps, dealing with the evil stepdaddy. Your pains? Well, you got $40 to $60 million for your pain. You took the oath.
I'm going to read a quote by the late Rodney King. And he go, right after the LA riot in 1992, the quote he say, after the riot, why can't we all just get along? Why can't we all just get along? And what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna pose that question to Kwame Brown and Hassan Campbell. Why can't we all just get along? You know, when you look back and you see, as far as like out there on YouTube, and even right now, I was watching this morning, as far as like Kwame Brown and Hassan Campbell, even trying to come together on the same platform and come to an understanding. And I watch Kwame Brown basically like replay, as far as Hassan Campbell own words and some of the things that he was saying, as far as like 18 years old, making cross comparison when they both was 18. Like Hassan Campbell stated that when he was 18, I guess he was fighting, okay, murder charge in a New York City correctional facility, whether it was on Rikers Island, the Bronx House, wherever it may be, but he was fighting for his life, for his freedom. At 18, Kwame Brown was the number one draft pick in the NBA, the National Basketball Association, drafted by one of the best players in the world, Michael Jordan. Okay, and Hassan Campbell wanted to say is, at 18, while he was fighting for his life, for his freedom because of a murder charge, you know, Kwame Brown was in practice getting elbowed, allegedly, in his face by Michael Jeffrey Jordan. And they started talking about pain. And he talking about Hassan saying right now, you know, being a kid, I guess living in the projects, you know, more or less like have to go to store with food stamp. Anybody that know, especially in the five boroughs, like it was embarrassing going to the store because you don't want like nobody to see you if you had food stamp. It didn't matter. Like, here it is. The food stamp was based upon for underprivileged family to have enough money to go to the local store to buy food, to feed the hungry family that was out there that was more or less like suffering because of, you know, they didn't have jobs, or they didn't have the right opportunity, or they didn't have the right education. So here it is. The kids, you know, or the parents used to have to go out there to utilize food stamp, you know, to purchase food, to feed the hunger. But we was embarrassed. Like right now, is guess what? Here it is, despite my mom's, guess what? She had a job. And you know what the game was back then? Saying you had people selling a food stamp. So here it is right now, back then, you know, people selling $200 worth of food stamp for $100 cash. That was the going rate. And even though my mother was buying a food stamp, if I had to go to the store with food stamp, you know what? I felt the way. Because I didn't want to be caught or nobody see me in the store buying food with food stamp, you know, because they're going to start talking and they're going to start thinking the wrong thing. But you know what? See, that's society. And that's what's wrong with us. So getting back to the Harshon Campbell, you know, versus Kwame Brown argument or whatever, it's like, you know, like Harshon stated, like, you know, had to wait on the cheese line to get free cheese from the welfare center. And what he was saying is, as far as right now is, you know, what Kwame Brown, you know, signing the NBA contract. It's like night and day. And it's, don't get me wrong, nobody can speak about pain. Everybody go to different pain. Everybody deal with pain differently. Everybody deal with life differently. It's like, what don't break us, make us. So it's no really, no comparison. Both of these men went through their own psychological pain. It doesn't matter whether it went through the prison system, went to the NBA. Guess what? It was still something that trickled down that affected us emotionally, mentally, spiritually, physically, to cause us to more or less have setback, cause trauma in our life. It doesn't matter. It happened. When you're being taken advantage of, or when you're being bullied, or when you're being like disrespected, people don't understand. Are you being beaten, you know, by your step parents or whoever, your mother, boyfriend? It doesn't matter. Guess what? It had a negative effect on your life. And it's different. And pain drive each and every one of us differently. You know, you look at the pain as far as that Harshon Campbell went through and what it caused him. The type of pain that he went through in his life and the trauma that he went to his life, it helped him to overcome each and every obstacle and making him, guess what? Top dog on a YouTube platform because of the pain. He utilized that pain and took that pain and make sure, guess what? The pain stopped here. And history won't be continued to repeat itself. Well, Kwame Brown, what he did is he took that pain of some of the things that he went through in his early age, as far as being broke, being hungry, becoming the number one draft pick in the NBA. And yet and still, what happened out of all that pain and suffering, he became the number one draft pick. And basically what he did was, guess what? He made a decent livelihood. He became successful in life because of the pain. Pain have a tendency, it can break you down to the core and destroy you, or it can make you into a better person. So with the pain, with Harshon Campbell, guess what? He took that pain and utilized it to the best of his ability. And guess what? He's one of the top YouTube blogger in these days and time today in 2021. Okay? Kwame Brown took that pain and he became the number one draft pick and was able to buy his mother home on a golf course, as he say. Powerful. I took my pain from the loss of my mother when she died. While I was incarcerated, I took that pain and decided, guess what? I was not gonna go back to jail. I was gonna not allow her teaching and upbringing to continue being vain. And you know what? 24 years later, guess what? I never went back and I'm not going back. So the difference is right now is my message to Harshon, to Kwame. You know what? Let's be like Rodney King. Why can't we just all get along? Thank you. Hit that like button, subscribe. Brian Clace Gibbs, one love.